Hello, my name is Dan Gelardi, and I'm BCBA with Brett DiNovi Associates. Today we'll be discussing rule-governed behavior. Rule-governed behavior serves an overall importance for behavior management along with society at large. This video will define rule-governed behavior, note some of its applications to applied behavior analysis, touch on the effect of rule-governed behavior in society, and give some general examples. What is rule-governed behavior? Simply, it is behavior under control of rules. In behavior analytic terms, the rule is seen as a verbal statement of antecedent behavior, consequence, contingency. So basically a description of what will happen before and after a person engages in a behavior. Rather than a person experiencing the behavior themselves, which is shaped by reinforcing or aversive consequences, known as contingency-shaped behavior. Tarbox and colleagues, 2011, states that by definition, one can follow a rule without ever contacting the contingencies it describes. Basically, a person engages in a behavior based on something they witnessed, they may have read, or were told about. Rules are intended to be guidelines for effective behavior. Williams and colleagues, in 1989, tells us that rule-governed behavior occurs due to a contact with rules that describe contingencies. In other words, someone tells you about it or you witness it to happen to another person. You can read it on a sign, a book, or manual, or watch a video, etc. And it's not due to prior contact with the actual contingencies themselves. Also, if it doesn't happen to you directly, but you gain enough understandable information in regards to the contingency to be made aware of the potential consequences. Rule-governed behavior helps people to remain safe from aversive consequences without experiencing them directly, such as the rule, look both ways before crossing the street. Therefore, you will likely remain safe and not be struck by an oncoming vehicle. So this chart, titled Rule-governed Behavior, put it into perspective, has different rules, contingencies, and also how it is rule-governed behavior. So in this example, the rule would be, do not touch the hot stove or you would get burned. And the contingency that you didn't previously experience is if you never touched the stove and therefore you never burned. What makes it rule-governed behavior is if you follow that contingency and you actually don't touch the stove, therefore you avoid being burned.
Let's talk about rule-governed behavior in the terms of rules versus shaping.
Rule-governed behavior in applied behavior analysis, which includes rules versus shaping. In rules versus shaping, responding may be more likely to come under the control of rules when contingencies are too weak, remote, or complex. Reinforcement is contingent on following the rule. Then we have self-rules, such as promoting independence in learners with developmental disabilities. Self-rules are defined as when a person repeats a rule covertly after following the same rule provided by others, or derived from their own observations and their interactions with previously reinforced situations. Learning to generate and follow self-rules can be a potentially useful self-management strategy for individuals that rely on external instructions or prompts, as stated in Falloon and Rayfield, 2008. For example, an individual who learned to put together a meal might be taught the chain task of assembling that meal by stating the self-rule prior to each step in the chain task. This allows less reliance on prompts and, more importantly, increased overall independence. Rules can enhance the speed and efficiency of DRO procedures and other contingency-based procedures, as stated in Watts 2013 and Williams and colleagues 1989. So then we have rules and reinforcement. Tarbox and colleagues 2011 suggests that people will follow rules because they have been reinforced for doing so in the past. A behavior plan with familiar rules or those that are similar can produce increasingly effective outcomes. Now that we're more familiar with rule-governed behavior and its current implications towards behavior management and society at large, where do we go from here? Tarbox Ethanol touches on some implications for future research in regards to rule-governed behavior. More research is needed to understand the attempts to establish the ability to follow rules that specify long-delayed consequences, such as death, cancer, retirement, career advancement, or non-existent consequences, such as going to hell, going to heaven, etc. Some research questions to ask are how do people create these rules? How effectively are they followed since they equate delayed consequences over instant or slightly delayed consequences? What role does society play in these rules? Do rules change over the span of a person's lifespan? I'd be interested in your comments below in regards to implications for future research. One final example of rule-governed behavior. Think about it this way. You just watch this video on rule-governed behavior, but you're not subscribed to this channel, but you want to. The only problem is you have never subscribed to any other YouTube channel before. You have never read or been told the description on how to do so. Well, you're in luck, since I'm going to state the rules needed to do so. You can simply click on the top right where it says to subscribe to this video, or you can scroll down slightly on this page and click subscribe. Remember to also click on the bell icon so you never miss any new content. And also share this video with your colleagues to spread the science of behavior. Thank you and stay safe.